I thank the gentleman for the time and for organizing this special order. And to be sure that folks do not think that local broadcasters are only important in the Midwest, I'm here representing New England. And we have many, many examples where our local broadcasters have really made a difference in Rhode Island. And I'd like to just, I think sometimes the best way to illustrate that is to give real examples of where that happened. And so, for example, there was a documentary made about a homeless man finding help at Crossroads, which is the largest homeless service organization in our state, in the state of Rhode Island. WPRI-TV, the local broadcaster in the city of Providence, secured the rights to this documentary and took the opportunity to create a telethon around its airing. Viewers were asked to open their hearts and their pocketbooks and pledge by phone or online, and that effort raised $85,000 for the shelter, providing greatly needed funding as the housing crisis and economy create an ever-growing demand for the shelter's services. So that's one example. Another example is while residents of our capital city, the city of Providence, waited for their electricity to be restored in their homes after Hurricane Irene cut off power to many in our state, WJAR-TV Providence simulcast the audio portion of its newscast on Clear Channel's WHJJ-AM Providence. This arrangement allowed locals to receive the TV station's around-the-clock coverage on battery-operated radios, which was obviously a very important service. In our state, we have a wonderful facility, a school called Meeting Street, which is an organization that provides individual learning programs for thousands of children with developmental disabilities. And Meeting Street is really allowed to tell the story of its wonderful school to the community each year during its annual telethon on WPRI-TV. This four-hour commercial-free telethon preempts primetime programming, and all production for the event is done in-house by the station. Last year, the telethon generated $500,000 from phone donations and long-term corporate commitments tied to the event, and it's raised millions of dollars over the years. The local newspaper and WNRI-AM in Woonsocket, Rhode Island, carry on the Milk Fund, which is a local tradition that started in 1936 as a way to help struggling families. And each year through the month of December, multiple fundraising efforts in Woonsocket raise money toward the purchase of milk vouchers. Another example, this past fall, listeners tuned in to WKKB-FM in Providence for its two-day Promesa y Esperanza, Promise and Hope, Radiothon, which raises funds for St. Jude's Children's Hospital. The broadcast is carried out in partnership with 15 sister stations throughout the country to raise awareness of childhood cancer within the Hispanic community and to help St. Jude continue to offer treatment to all children, regardless of their family's ability to pay. This year's effort raised more than $100,000 in WKKB's listening area alone and more than $630,000 between the 16 stations combined. And just one final example, Alin Media, which owns WPRI-TV in East Providence, established the Minority Scholarship and Training Program. Each recipient receives a two-year scholarship for up to $10,000 per year, which can be used towards school expenses. And in addition, Alin Media provides each student with hands-on training through a paid internship program at one of its television stations around the country. The Minority Scholarship recipients are assigned full-time positions at Alin Media upon graduation and successful completion of the training program. So these are just some examples, and I know there are examples like this all across the country, where local broadcasters are really making a difference, not only helping raise needed resources for nonprofit organizations, getting information to listeners and viewers during emergencies, but really helping to strengthen our communities. And I, for one, want to acknowledge the local broadcasters and say thank you. And I hope these examples help illustrate the value of our local broadcasters. And I really thank the gentleman for organizing this special order hour and for the time. And I yield back.